What's up, YouTube? This is your boy Jonas. I'm here with my beautiful wife,
Jen,
and our adorable daughter,
Naomi.
Naomi, yeah. Say what's up, Naomi. Right there, camera.
See the baby?
Yeah, right there. You see yourself?
See?
Oh, okay. No. This is a 7-month video update of Naomi, of course. And yes, Naomi just turned 7 months 2 days ago. Mm-hmm. So she's really excited. As you can see, she's getting ultra big.
Yep.
From last time you guys saw. So last time we did a video, Naomi.
4 or 5 months she was in it, I think.
Yeah, she wasn't in the last video, the 6-month video, but she was in the last, the 5-month video. So Naomi, get up so they can see you. People want to see you. Yes. She's kind of in. She sees Daddy has on his glasses, so she's kind of like weird out. She's kind of weird out about that. So let's get right into it. Speaking of Naomi, I mean, of course, this is about Naomi. She knows her name now. Mm-hmm. If you call her and she's like trying to break something on the entertainment system or pull something down off the couch and you say Naomi, she'll turn around and look at you and then go back to breaking whatever she was breaking or getting into whatever she was getting into. So that's mm-hmm. a cool thing because it's so awesome
to know her name.
So she knows her name now. So
she's kind of been probably recognized it for a while.
Between 6.5 months, I think. Yeah. She started like really like.
We noticed that if you said her name, she would turn around and look.
Before so. It was just like.
Randomly, if she heard your voice, she would turn. Now she knows her name and she'll specifically turn for that.
Yourself?
He's staring at the baby.
I know.
So Naomi is, as you can see, she's a little skinny, I guess you could say. I don't know. She is great, but she weighs about 15 pounds or 6.8 kilos. I put her. We have like a kilogram scale, and I sat her on that, and it was 6.8. So that's just a little bit shy of 15 pounds. But that's not a concern. I don't know what percentile that is at the moment.
We haven't went to the doctors in a while.
Right.
So.
Our next appointment is at 9 months. So we don't know her percentiles. But they are not worried at all about that. Next.
Still a cranky sleeper. Our sleeping habits, they fluctuate. They're all over the place still. But overall, she's a good sleeper when it comes down to it. When she needs the rest, she gets the adequate amount of rest, what Naomi needs. So we still have to rock her to sleep. As far as naps, she takes naps ranging from 20 minutes to 2 hours. She's got up from a nap, and it was only another 20-minute nap. Mm-hmm. So, like I said, her naps vary. Sleeping varies, but majority of the night she'll sleep. It just all depends on which day it is and how I guess Naomi's feeling. And you know, that's one of the things that you know we got to get used to. We are used to it now, I guess.
Yeah, she still sleeps. She sleeps in our room. Occasionally, she sleeps in the bed with us. I try and push for her to sleep in her pack and play.
And I try to push for her to sleep in the bed with us. And which is probably a bad habit because I don't know. When Jen's at work, majority of the time she sleeps in the bed mm-hmm. with me. So it's kind of a bad habit because I just like sleeping with my little baby girl. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You like it too?
You agree?
Yeah.
Breastfeeding.
So as far as her eating, so she did start to get some solids. Probably a little bit before, 6 months, we started introducing some solids, but not like on a regular basis or with any kind of consistency, just, here and there, we would let her taste some stuff. And even like now, she is very interested in our food, like something that we are eating. And she can be aggressive as far as like her wanting it.
Yes.
Ouch. Did you hit yourself? So she does eat some of our food, but she's not really into being spoon-fed. She just doesn't really like that.
I would say, yeah, some days she likes it, and some days she's like, hey, don't put that spoon in my mouth.
Right, she'd rather do it herself.
Yeah.
She's more interested in eating things that she can feed herself. So something that I have been trying with her is the pouches. And, you know, she likes that because she can kind of bring it to her mouth with my guidance, and she'll eat from that. And she's even gotten the little sucking from it, like sucking the food out of it. She's gotten that too. So she can, she likes that better. So not really purees, just mostly breastfeeding and every now and then that stuff.
Moving right along, one thing we noticed too, her babbling along, or her baby language or baby talking, is starting to sound more and more like words. Mm-hmm. We think we got a dada a couple of days back.
Or a daddy. But that, like in the midst of her babbling, she would say that.
Yeah,
like
so she's sounds. Doing, she's definitely starting to get more close to words, I guess. Dada or daddy, and mm-hmm. she'll say da-da-da-da-da for a long time, and mm-hmm. she'll occasionally say ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma, and then she'll go off and say ja-ja-ja-blah-blah-blah-blah-blah-blah.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why she's looking at me right now, because I'm talking her language, so yeah, she's getting close to, her words are starting to sound like,
She is still like super active and into things, and so I have deemed this remote her remote. It's like a spare remote, so I took the batteries out of, so that it's something that I can switch and give her while I'm kind of going a little bit. We have a list, and I'm kind of going off topic, but so she does have tantrums sometimes, and so you know, to get her away from things that she's not supposed to have, I, you know, often will like replace it with something that she can have.
Then and you have to make a trade with her.
Right, make a trade. Because now if you take something away from her, she can kind of get pissed. So this is her remote, and she can play with it. It doesn't have batteries, and it's not going to change the TV.
And like Jen said, like Jen touched on, she's still super active. She, our place is not that big. I don't think it's not that big, but mm-hmm. this girl is all over this place. I'm afraid when she learns how to walk upstairs, because once she learns that, then it's over. Because she's mm-hmm. every time I'm watching her, I don't watch her. You know, I'm a guy, so I'm just watching. I'm not on her butt. I'm just listening for like sounds. So. I just hear the sounds like when she's in the kitchen, or when she's over there by the door, and when she's over there by the dining room table. So she's, mm-hmm. like I said, she's all over the place. She's still active, very aware of her surroundings, though. She's always trying to do something new. As you can see, she, like Jen said, this room, we had to get another channel changer and take the batteries out of here, because she's always trying to... figure out how to make the TV change. Mm-hmm. I think she's like, I think she likes doing that, because she even go to the cable box and mash buttons on there and look up at the TV and see if it changes. So I think she's kind of like starting to put things together, like connect the two. Definitely when we're on the phone talking, she understands that, like
she wants the phone.
Yeah, she wants the phone. Like, hey, what are you doing? I see you talking on the phone. So
kinda. What I do is, like, when Jonas calls, I put the phone on speaker and then lock the phone so she can't push any buttons, and I let her hold the phone so that she can hear Daddy, and she can babble and talk to Daddy too.
And then that transitions right over to what our next topic is about her following objects. Just mm-hmm. like I said, she's starting like to put two and two together and connect things.
Mm-hmm. Like she just dropped her toy, and so she looks down to see her toy and get it.
So she's starting to follow objects. Like mm-hmm. I was in the, we were in the restroom the other day, and she so happened to spill something in the tub, and she was like really trying to go after it after that, and so and to the point where she was like trying to tilt herself over, and so I didn't want to hurt herself, so I put her in the tub, and she got whatever she knocked over in the tub, and started playing with it. As you see, she knows this is a game now.
She also, like, if you're hiding behind a corner, you know, like if you like kind of play peekaboo or whatever with her, she'll like peer over, like, where'd you go? I see you, and that kind of a thing. So she's pretty good.
Some of Naomi's favorite foods, favorite snacks, is these things they call the puffs.
Yeah.
She loves those things. Those things are like lifesavers. So especially for my male viewers out there, if you're ever out and about with your little one, grab you some Puffs, because they are like, they're lifesavers, because Naomi could be screaming from a, like, it sounds like she's screaming from a mountaintop, but if I pop one of those things in her mouth, she just chews it right up, and she's quiet, and I just do it every 30 seconds, because she eats them like candy.
Yeah, I buy like the Happy Bellies or Happy Baby, whatever it is. And so far, she's tried the sweet potato and the greens.
I think she likes the sweet potato the best.
Mm-hmm. And so she eats those up. She doesn't quite do this yet. She grabs them with her whole hand and isn't not always successful getting them in her mouth. So we still have to kind of help her. But it does help. Like, I'll put her in her little high chair seat and put the chair in the kitchen with me and throw some little Puffs on there while I'm trying to cook, and that entertains her. So,
yep, that's pretty much it. What's going on with 7 months? I wish we knew more, but like I said, things are,
as you can see, she's busy.
Yeah, things are going well. As she tries to bite mom's shoulder, things are going well. Name is doing awesome, we're doing awesome, and I guess we'll see you guys in 30 more days for 8th month.
Mm-mm. Crazy.
All right, guys, have a good one.
Say deuces. Bye. Deuces.
Say deuces. Right there. Yeah. All right, guys.